coming to you from the Junior Duck Stamp Competition. Hi everyone, welcome to the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service's Conservation Connect, where we learn about awesome conservation careers, new wildlife species, and all kinds of technology that conservation professionals use to study and protect wildlife. I'm Chelsea McKinney, your host.
And I'm your co-host, Travis Weller. And today we're coming to you from the home of the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, the National Conservation Training Center.
That's right, Travis. And we have a lot of excitement here today because we are watching the Junior Duck Stamp Competition, which exposes hundreds of thousands of youth all the way from kindergarten to 12th grade every year to learn about wetlands, national wildlife refuges, and various species of ducks through art. Today we have Lionel Grant, the Michigan U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service coordinator, to tell us more. Mr. Grant, it's so great to meet you, and thank you so much for coming here to be a part of the Junior Duck Stamp Competition.
All right, I'm glad to be here. Thanks.
Can you tell us, what is the Junior Duck Stamp Competition?
Yes, the Junior Duck Stamp Competition is a unique opportunity, for youth to be excited and learn about wildlife, but also learn about how to express that love that they have for waterfowl as well as a bunch of nature here with the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service. It's a wonderful program because it blends the classroom as well as expression of art in the same program. There's an individualized curriculum that is set out for students that are throughout the U.S. and either if they're in kindergarten, and it ranges all the way to the 12th grade. And in addition to that, it has a wonderful art program contest, which we're here for today, where youth just get a chance to exhibit their skills and talents for this once a year.
Well, we're looking at some technology, actually, that was invented by Fish and Wildlife Service personnel, which is pretty cool. And the biggest piece of technology we have is this. This is the firing portion of a cannon net.
A
cannon net. Yeah, and the name is self-explanatory. It was developed on one of our Missouri refuges by some maintenance workers. And basically, what we do is we put a charge in here. This is a heavy cast iron cannon. Okay. And then a net is fed into it. And the net shoots out in a perfect world. It opens gently. And then it will fall either on waterfowl. We actually use these exact type of nets to capture the last California condors that came out of the wild.
Wow.
And it captures them without harming them. And then we can go out and tag them. So these bands, they're colored, which means you actually don't have to be as close to the bird as other bands to see all the information. They have numbers on them to identify in our database where this bird has come from, how many there are. And these would go on the smallest birds, perhaps migratory songbirds or other very small migratory waterfowl and so on.
And each of these bands has a different number that's only unique.
That's the point of it, so we can tell exactly how many of any particular species or even subgroup are migrating. Our largest bands are these big green bands, and these would go on the largest birds that migrate in North America, swans and geese and these type of birds. We'd have a larger band where you can see the number easily with binoculars and so on, and we'd use them for those type of birds.
And it's very decorative. It would look good on your neck.
It would. I mean, as a bander, you could carry a bunch of them out to the cannon net where the birds are trapped temporarily.
Science and style. Right?
Or you could put them on your shoulder, and that's an easy way to carry these rather large bands.
Awesome. Well, Mark, thank you so much for showing us all the cool technology that's used to study waterfowl.
You're very welcome. It's my pleasure.
Behind me, we've got the Wildwood Middle School students who have just watched the end and results of the Junior Duck Stamp Competition, and they've decided to come out here and make some duck artwork of their own. Travis is going to go interview them and see what they've produced.
What are you drawing?
I'm drawing a mallard duck.
What are you doing? What's the process you're doing right now?
I'm coloring in the head of the duck.
What do you think is the most difficult about drawing it?
Mixing the colors to make the perfect green of the head of the duck.
And what is your favorite thing about the mallard duck?
The bright yellow beak.
That's a really good drawing.
Thank you.
What's your name?
Audrey Davis.
What's your favorite part about the mallard duck, Audrey?
Its green head is really pretty and distinguishes what kind of species it is.
What's your favorite part about the mallard duck, Arion?
I think it's a really beautiful duck.
I like that bow on the head.
Thank you.
What do you like about art?
Everybody has their different interpretations of art and have different works and think different ways. And it shows how each person is unique.
Hi, what's your name?
Ben Franks.
What are you drawing?
I'm drawing a duck.
I like the shading
Thanks. That
you're using. What's your favorite thing about the mallard duck?
I think it has very different colors.
What's your favorite part about art?
I like how you can do anything you want.
Hi, Jennifer.
Hi there, Travis.
What year did you win the federal duck stamp competition?
I actually won in 2014. However, my stamp will actually be made in 2015, so it will come out this year.
What duck did you draw?
I painted the ruddy duck.
And what advice do you have for the young artists?
First, paint and draw what you like to draw. Follow your passions. Enjoy studying the things that you like to draw, whether it's nature or fantasy. We live in a beautiful world and there's a lot to see and you can draw it all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
If you love art, make sure you enter the Junior Duck Stamp Competition next year. You can find out more about it right on the website below. Thanks everyone, and we'll see you guys next time on the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service's Conservation Connect.